Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel and welcome to my new subscribers. So today's reading, the idea came from one of my subs, Katie, so thank you for this. So this is, what are your hidden talents and gifts? So for group one we have the orange jasper apple. For group two we have the, I'll just say, jade apple. For group three, we have the tiger's eye apple. Okay, so take what resonates, leave what doesn't, and don't forget these energies as well, guys. If anything comes out, you know, in regards to what your gifts are. So anyway, I see you at your poles. Hey, group one. So if you chose the orange jasper apple, this is your reading. So let's see what gifts. Hidden gifts you've got. Okay, so we've got counseling. You heal with kind words, wise advice, and an empathic ear. And we've got creative expression. Your soul longs to express itself creatively. You know me. Oh, I'm melting up here. Oh my goodness. So anyway, the reason I chose two cards, I should have said that at the beginning really, two cards, is because, you know, there's a number of people that watch this. So for some of you it could be counselling, for some of you it is your creative expression, so like drawing, painting, it can even be writing, anything that's creative, making things. It could even be both, okay? You may have both of these talents. So what I'm picking up here, your hidden gift is, I feel like group one, you are empaths. So you may find a lot of people turn to you for advice, you know, a comforting ear or comforting words, you know, that kind of thing. So you give people really, really good advice. And you tend to heal people with that advice, you know, with the way you speak, the way you treat people. So let's have a look at this even more. So tell me more for group one, their hidden gifts and their hidden talents, please, Spirit. So we've got the dreamer. I just need to double check because these are new and, you know, get stuck together. And then we've got the Prince of Autumn. So, so that's the Knight of Pentacles, I think. I think it is. So on these cards, okay, they do have words. So they, the Fool actually says, the Dreamer says, embrace your true purpose, begin a new adventure, trust yourself. And then the Prince of Autumn says, dependable, protective, chivalrous, humorous, and then cautious but wise action, meticulous attention to detail, kindness to others. There you go. And this is somebody that is very loyal as well, you know. You can tell this, you guys, I'm talking about you group one. You could tell, people could tell you guys anything that you know, that they want. And you will never, ever go and repeat it. You will never go gossip about it. You will never judge people about it. That's why I feel like maybe counselling, therapy, that kind of thing, may be where your hidden talents lie. It's that healing energy that you have. And you're very protective as well, like this card says. So it even could be that you use humour sometimes. You know, and I tend to do that. When people are really upset, I'll say something quite funny, you know, and then they're laughing in the next breath, you know. Because sometimes laughter is very, very healing, you know. But the Fool here is taking that leap of faith. So maybe you've been thinking about it. Maybe you've not had time to do it because maybe family and life gets in the way. So tell me a bit more, please, Spirit. So we do have Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So tell me more about group one's hidden gifts and talents. You know, Spirit is just saying at the moment, just take that leap of faith, you know, what is holding you back. So we've got Justice, the Hermit, and the Emperor. Okay, three major arcanas just come out. Oh no, four. Okay, four major arcanas just come out. Okay, So this is something huge in your life that's going to be coming up, or something huge that you're going to be thinking about that's going to change your life, okay? With so many, yeah, look, we've even got the renewal, okay, which is 20. It is judgment. So on these cards, okay, justice is all about fairness, okay, putting things into balance or into perspective. It could be that you've been denying this for a very long time, you know, denying yourself of what makes you happy, what you've wanted to do. Like I said, maybe family's got in the way, you know, life has just got in the way of following your dreams here. So in this card, it actually says, take time to review the details carefully. You will win in the end, fair and objective decisions. Now the Hermit, this card speaks of you finding maybe a mentor, take a break from, you know, society, people, you know, just life in general. Take time out, spend some time alone, develop your spiritual growth as well, because maybe meditation with spirit might end up giving you that little nudge or that encouragement or signs in the right direction. You know, spirit usually does point us in the right direction. It's whether we listen to those messages. Most of the time we tend to ignore them. You know, life would be a lot easier if we actually listened to it. So, you know, with the Emperor, this is all about structure, okay, planning. You can, you know, becoming more organized. And also that's leadership as well. And renewal with judgment as well here, okay? So we've got review the past and present so you can plan a bright new future. Understanding your life purpose, releasing judgments of yourself and others. And I am reading these cards, even though, you know, I can read tarot, whatever. I know what tarot's all about, but these messages on these cards, that's why I really like these cards. These are new. They're giving you like a different perspective of what, you know, how to look at things. So in this card, it's actually saying you've got a bright future, but with judgment, you need to come to a decision. You need to make, you know, plans for yourself. It's like a final wake-up call, basically. Is that like, is this all I want to do? Is this all I'm going to get out of life? Is there something better for me? So it's like I'm seeing you questioning everything recently, group one. I mean, you've started off with zero. You literally started off with zero, which is taking a leap of faith and jumping into the unknown, you know. That's what the Fool is all about, is the unknown, but it's always rewarding at the end of the day. Obviously, if it wasn't, then I would actually say, you know, just be cautious. So what advice would you give Group One Spirit? How should they pursue this? If you wanted to pursue it, we've got the Queen of Autumn in reverse, Ten of Winter, Ten of Autumn. These are endings that are coming into your life, you know, final, making final decisions and things that you're going to complete. We've got the Prince of Spring and the Queen of Summer. So that's the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Pentacles. West Winter, Ten of Swords, Ten of Pentacles, and the Knight of Wands. You've got Judgment again, guys. This has come out twice. I'm going to clarify that. Judgment has literally come out twice. Yeah, the Ten of Autumn is the Ten of Pentacles, which is generational wealth. It's leaving a legacy to your children, okay? It's being very successful in what it is that you do or what it is that you want to do. It's just literally finding the confidence to move forward with this, if this is exactly what you want to do, find that passion again. Especially if it is to do with being creative, maybe family has got in the way. Maybe you were told you were not good enough, because the Ten of Swords is being feeling betrayed, feeling let down, being put down as well, saying that you're not good enough, But we've got. You've come out like this, guys. Here's the love inside of you guys, comforting, emotional, intuitive, which is like counseling. You listen, you give advice, people trust you. But then it's like two sides to you. It's like you've got the devil on the shoulder and the angel on your shoulder, and you've got this side of you here, that this is like what goes on internally with you, group one. It's like, I'm not good enough. I can never have a career for myself. I can never do this. I haven't got the confidence or even down to us saying to ourselves, I don't have the brain to do it. I'm not intelligent, blah, blah, blah. This is what I'm seeing here. You're overlooking at the fact that you've got this gift here of the Queen of Cups, which is just, you have a beautiful energy, guys. A beautiful energy. And you've got so much to give. And look at all the fairies. It's like the fairies are lighting your way, but it's like you're not seeing that gift that you have. You're doubting yourself with the Queen of Swords. The Queen, what did I say? The Queen of Swords, maybe that's you feeling you need to protect yourself. Maybe, like, you've been hurt in the past, like I said, being put down, not feeling confident enough. But yeah, the Queen of Pentacles. And it also could be, guys, I'm looking at these two like this. You may be ungrounded at the moment, so maybe what you need to do is some grounding meditation to put yourself back into alignment, so you become more grounded. But the only reason you're like this, group one, is because somebody along the way has told you you're not good enough, and it's now trying to change that mindset of, I am good enough. Take it as a lesson with judgment. Take that as a valuable lesson, Spirit wants you to wake up. It's like Spirit is like shaking you guys, saying, wake up, this is your purpose. Even with these two, looking at these two now, actually, you have those counselors, that therapists, whatever you guys call them, okay, we call therapists, whatever, that work with children, and when they're trying to find out if something went wrong with the child, what they do is they get them to draw through, expressing themselves through drawing. So this could be part of what this is as well. Working with children, creative expression, getting kids to express themselves. There's something here that you are supposed to be doing. It's going to bring you so much success. It's like guaranteed lifetime success here, okay? Yeah, this is what I feel like. Maybe this is what you should be doing. It's something to do with those two cards right there. I want to get some oracle cards as well, because sometimes the oracle cards can give us a little bit more, and then if I have to clarify with the tarot, then I will. So we do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well, guys. So Spirit, tell me please. Group one's hidden gifts and talents. Any advice on that? Repetition. Sometimes in order to move forward, you must repeat situations in order to learn important lessons, patterns, routine, habits. So that could be what's going on in your life at the moment, group one, okay? That things are just becoming repetitive, okay? You're just even repeating the same mistakes or even the same mindset, the same faults. Until you change that, change your energy, change your surroundings, change the way you think, it's just going to keep being this like hamster wheel, basically. You're just going to keep going around and around and around. It's getting out of this mindset that I can't do it. Divine vision. Get out of your own way. That's what I just was basically saying. Get out of your own way. Discard your projected outcomes and allow yourself to see beyond. Positive focus. Look deeper. Also, this could be you guys going through a spiritual awakening right now. Maybe your third eye is starting to open up, or maybe you need to develop your third eye. Okay? You know, the Queen of Cups is a psychic as well as an empath. So, right, okay. So pause and reflect. Be mindful of your self-talk. Thank you. And solve your problems with the fullest mental clarity, stagnation, release, stillness. This is what I've been saying. It's the way you're thinking about yourself. It's just so much. So much has happened in your life, group one, and your confidence has been knocked through the wall, okay? It's like someone's literally just booed you right through the wall, and they've kept doing that. Whoever these people are, you need to change that mindset and tell yourself that you are good enough. And then we've got prelude. You may feel not much is happening, however, the path you are on is leading you to something great. Groundwork, first step, intro. Yeah, you need to do the groundwork first, group one. If you know, if you want to follow this new career, or I should have actually said it was a career reading as well, but never mind. Your hidden talents, your creativity, whatever, you need to do some groundwork on yourself. You need to start with you first, not anybody else, you. And I totally get it. I sometimes self-sabotage, meant like, you know, I do it to myself, but that's more the way I think, because that's been ingrained in me as well for years, where I believed that I was never good enough to do anything, basically. You know, that's just, you know, that's nothing to do with me. Obviously, it's your upbringing and the people around you that always have to say that, you know, you're not good enough. But over the years, I've changed my mindset by meditation, affirmations, things like that, because I'm good enough. That's what you should be saying. I didn't say I'm confident. No, I am good enough. You guys need to start doing that as well, okay? So tell me more, please, Spirit, about group ones, hidden gifts and talents. You know, that, like I said at the beginning, the fall is very important there. There's a change coming if it is what you want, if you want to change things. So we've got the flame, passion and creativity. Let your inner spark, there you go, light your path. I mean, you've got creative there, you've got creativity here. You've had that on a few of these cards here as well, guys. So it's find that flame, find that spark. And it's like, when I was looking at this card, I said, look, all the fairies lighting the way here. Look at the lights that they're holding here. And it's like, she's looking at the one fairy, but she's not noticing all the other fairies around her. You know? I feel like this fairy here is, yeah, she's got a trumpet. So it's like this fairy's blowing a trumpet. You know, and I'm seeing that as judgment. Because in judgment, they're blowing a trumpet. And you've had the judgment card come out twice. And it says here, actually, I didn't even see that because I don't really like to read many things on tarot cards anyway. But it says here, listen to your heart, intuitive insights you can trust, taking care of others perhaps too much. okay, taking care of too many like people with their problems, and it can become draining, especially if you're an empath, and these are like energy vampires, guys, as well. So you need to be careful. You need to be protecting your energy as much as you can. But I feel like sometimes these people, group one, that you're taking care of too much, is the ones that don't believe in you, that don't give you the support, don't give you the ear, don't give you the shoulder to lean on when you need it. Yeah, I bet if you needed it, they wouldn't be there. Anyway, let's have a look at the rest of these. We've got the healer. It's time of healing. Use this time to restore balance, whether physical, mental, and spiritual. But this is also you being a healer. This is also you healing yourself. And then the dragon. Power and strength. Unleash your inner power. Yeah, you might, your spirit animal might actually be a dragon. Your Chinese horoscope may be the dragon as well, group one. Embrace that inner dragon. And then we've got the cosmic dance. You are part of a grand cosmic ballet. Embrace change and fluidity. I said it. Oh my God, I don't know, you guys listen to me sometimes. Let's see. So spirit, tell me more for group one, their hidden gifts and talents. So we've got the little things. Find the little things in your everyday life that make you happy, and one day you'll realize they are the big things. And then you've got auric field. Your vibe is a gift. It is time to clear your auric field and protect it. Purify and restore your energy. Maybe you want to Google that word, guys, because I really need to Google. Maybe it's like your aura. I think that's what that is your aura. So obviously they've calling it auric. Yeah, that's your aura. You need to cleanse that. You need to clear that. That might actually help you heal. Then you've got spiritual growth. Prioritize your spiritual growth and don't allow the cares of life to squeeze out your goal to grow spiritually. And then you've got happy ending. Though it may not seem like it now, but you will accomplish far more than you can ever imagine. Your story will have a happy ending. You've had that a couple of times. And the Ten of Pentacles is a happy ending as well. Now, I want to... So, Spirit, tell me, advice for group one on how to help develop these gifts or learn. Four of Swords in reverse, the Lovers in reverse, the Hierophant in reverse. There's something very unbalanced here, guys. This is... It could be you guys going for a spiritual awakening at the moment, or it could be when you start going for a spiritual awakening, you may end up finding that relationships, and this is what happens when you go for a spiritual awakening, okay, group one, is what happens is you realize that people around you, the people you've invested in, are literally, what words can I call them, a waste of time, okay, I'm going to say it in a polite way, a literal waste of time. And that's what you start awakening to, is what is important, your spirituality, the people that are good to you, the people that are not good to you. You know, it's like having a clear out. So the people that you showed love and respect, the ones that never gave it back, it's not about tit for tat, it's about having mutual love and respect from people that should be showing it to you when you are showing it to them. I hope you understand what I'm saying. So you're going to be going through a spiritual awakening and literally having a big clear out. Okay. These energies of people that give you bad advice. They're not supportive at all. They are that. These are people as well that may live like unconventionally, you know, different to you. They're not. I'm trying to be polite. I mean, I don't know why, because it's not usually like me, but no, I am polite. It's just that they're different. I'm trying to get it out. What's going to happen here, okay, is you will look at these friends and family members and what have you, and you're going to see that the path that they are on, still doing the same things, maybe going out partying, putting it about, that kind of thing, okay? Toxic relationships, it could be people just toxic in gossiping and things like that. You're going to start awakening to who you want in your life. And I feel like that is going to lead to the path of an awakening for you, as well as towards your happy ending here and your spiritual growth. I can see that happening. Yeah. The thing is here, okay, you may come from a background group one that you don't have. I know how that feels. Yeah, because look, we've got the Four of Wands, and I was just about to say family. Yeah, look at this. Literally, what I was just about to say before turning these cards over is that you guys may be people that don't really have family, okay? So you may treat your friends as your family because you're very loyal, and you're looking for that security and that stability in either relationships or friendships, but they're wrong for you, okay? It's affecting your gifts, it's affecting your spiritual growth. So this is why I said about family. It's finding your soul family, but this, I feel like these people in your life are not your soul family. We've got the Three of Cups, which is a friendship group, but then look what's happening here. What is actually happening is that you could be attracting karmics constantly. These energies here, this friendship group, or even family members, have caused you an injustice. They've been unfair to you. They've not treated you right. They've not treated you with respect. And this is the awakening that you are going to have. I feel like this is what makes you ungrounded as well. This is the Ten of Swords and the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Is that these people tell you, no, you can't do it. What are you going to do that for? You know, isn't that I hate people that make you doubt yourself. I really do. Trust me, I've had those as well that you think, you know, but, So we do have Libra as well, guys. We do have Gemini and we do have Taurus. So I'm going to get a last bit of advice for you, okay? And then maybe a couple of more oracle cards. Actually, no, I don't need to get no more advice. This is the advice from Spirit. Until you either awaken to what's going on around you, you're never going to be able to move forward. You're just going to keep doing the repetition. You know? Is that it, Spirit? Yeah, Spirit's saying, leave it there. I do want to get you guys, is it these ones? Yeah, because sometimes these can give you good advice on what to clear out and stuff as well. So for group one, please, Spirit. What did I say? I said that a minute ago, did I not? Where is that card? Where are you? Why am I speaking like that? I don't know. But anyway, I said about the third eye opening, and you've literally got this card here. Your intuition is on point now, and you see beyond the veil. Maybe you guys are in the process of opening that third eye. Reflection. As you gaze into your past, you see the way to the future. Yep. And that can be the Hermit energy as well, group one, that take time alone, reflect, meditate, whatever it is that you guys do for reflection. Because it's going to make you look to the past. I mean, I had a spiritual awakening about 4 years ago, and that's when I literally woke up to the people around me of how selfish they were. And that's what you've got to start doing. Maybe even look into a crystal ball. other one, please, Spirit. Book of Shadows, you are empowered by shining a light on the darkness. And that's it. You're of light, guys. You bring so much light, and hence energy vampires. People, the dark tend to suck the light. You know, they want that light. Queen of Cups is of light. Yeah. I'm going to get a message from your angels, actually, guys. I think that's important. I've got no room. So, message for group one. You've got Aureli. New psychic, oh my goodness, new psychic and spiritual experience are on the are changing the way you view the world. I might as well not even bother with the oracle card. Seriously, it's literally just it clarify. Yeah. Anyway, I'll shut up. New psychic and spiritual experience are changing the way you view the world and yourself. Allow your spiritual gifts to open through study, prayer, and meditation. I've been saying this throughout the whole reading. The whole reading. I have a gift, group one. A gift that needs to be developed. And like I said, maybe life is getting in the way. Maybe family is getting in the way. And it's now time to take time out for yourself, you know. I've advised a few people that if you haven't got time during the day or you can't seem to concentrate on meditation, you know, some of these people have taken this advice and it's working. Do it just as you're going to sleep. Because your subconscious then is open more to taking it in and listening to, you know, the meditation music or affirmations, whatever. But this needs to be developed. But the new experiences, spiritual experience, are changing the way you view the world and yourself. And this is what I was just saying, that you're going to start viewing people in such a different light. And you're going to be like, I'm done with all this. There's just so much more out there. So many better people out there. That is such a beautiful card that came out from your angels there, group one. And let's get one from your spirit guide. So for group one, please, Spirit. And I wasn't going to use that card. Well, this deck, should I say. It was sitting there from a reading I did the other day. So I thought, why not? And these. So let's see. So gratitude. Life is one big continuous circle of giving and receiving energy. Be thankful for who and what's in your life instead of complaining about what you don't have. If you focus on gratitude, you'll start to attract prosperity and abundance. So let's get a question for you, group one. It don't have to be about this, it can be about anything, okay? So think of it, ask it. So for group one, please, Spirit. So you've got a few years from now. It may take some time, but your efforts will not go unnoticed. So, great one. If you like this reading, please hit like. I appreciate you guys. If you guys are new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you. And you guys have a beautiful day. Much love. Hey, group two. So if you chose the Jade Apple, this is your reading. So let's see what your hidden talents and gifts are. So we've got Builder. Your innate ability to build and create brings you a deep sense of accomplishment. Okay. And then Travel. Your life purpose involves traveling. So I did pick two cards because there, you know, a number of people watch these readings. So some of you may have a gift of building things, you know, even buildings. I mean, it can end up taking you traveling, you know, abroad. I love these two cards. They're actually two guys with angel wings. I never noticed that before. Could even be an architect as well, something that you create online, or you know, it could be anything that you create online basically. It is something that you are talented in creating something. I mean, some of you, I don't know why that came to my head, may even be I know it's maybe not a gift, but it is a gift in a way, is being a pilot, or to become a pilot, geez. you know, that kind of thing. Even building planes, you know, even model planes. I'm just seeing something very creative here that maybe you guys did it when you were younger, but you didn't really continue it when you got older, if you know what I mean. You just sort of left it to the side, and maybe it's been niggling at you lately that you just want to change something, you want to start it again. But anyway, I'm going to use these cards, okay? These are new, actually. I quite like them. They are actually tarot cards. I forgot what they're called. I think it's a fairy tarot, but they give you different insights on certain cards. So yeah, let's have a look. So tell me more about, actually I'm going to clarify these two cards and then I'll ask Spirit that. So tell me for group two, please, Spirit, about this builder card and this travel card. What is these hidden gifts and talents? The Eight of Autumn. So, hang on. That is the Eight of Pentacles, work, building something. Three of Summer, which is the Three of Cups. Love it. Tell me more about this builder and travel card. The Empress, wow. So on the Eight of Autumn, on this card it says, do more research before proceeding. Education in the form of seminars, going back to school or apprenticeships, excellent craftsmanship and long-term projects. Wow. So this could be, you know, like I said, an architect or just even being a builder. I mean, we all need builders, you know. There's something here that you need to craft, you know, what's the word? Honing on that craftsmanship. So you may need to go back to school, but maybe that's what's stopping you, because you're thinking to yourself, oh, I don't know, maybe I'm too old to go back to school. No one's ever too old to go back to school. So the Three of Summer is news worth celebrating, announcements such as weddings, graduations, births, friends you cherish. So I feel like with this, okay, hang on, I'm going to come back to that. And then we've got the Empress, the Divine Feminine. Time to take action. The power of creativity, success that allows your life, allows for a life of luxury. Now, what I'm seeing here is you do have a really good friendship group, or just people around you that are very supportive or will be very supportive of this. I feel like they're going to be excited for you. You know, and once you build up the courage, build up the courage to pursue this dream that you have, you've got a life of luxury here. It's going to bring you so much success. I'm just seeing success here for you guys. It could even lead to new friends as well. But what I'm seeing here, it could be maybe what's stopping you from pursuing this is because you could have a family. You know, there could be children at home. You could be in a committed relationship here, and maybe you feel a bit guilty of going back to school and pursuing what you want. It could be that your children have flown the nest now and it's like, well, what do I want to do with myself? And this has been pushed to the background because you've been nurturing your children, you know. But now it's time for you, is what I'm seeing. And you do have the encouragement there from other people. This is lovely. So tell me more about group two's hidden gifts and talents, please, Spirit. We've got Judgment, make a decision. Spirit is saying here, it's time to wake up. You know, what is it that you want to do? What is it that you want out of life? It also says here, review the past and the present so you can plan a bright future. Understanding your life purpose, releasing judgments on yourself and others. But if judgments is not that you're judging yourself, it's more of you, if, because the Empress, she's selfless, okay? She's not, and I'm saying she because it's a she card, okay? But it is energies, guys. She's not selfish. She puts other people's needs, wants, thoughts, feelings, everything before everybody else, before her own. And this is why I feel like judgment has come out here. So tell us a bit more, please, Spirit. So we have ego. Which is the devil. Illusions, the illusion of being trapped, placing too much importance on material items, getting caught up in fear and worry. Yeah, there you go. See, look, you've got another group that basically Spirit has given you quite a lot of major arcana. Okay, this is a major event that's going to take place in your life, or a major decision that you need to make, because it is going to change your life, and it's going to change it for the better. Because we do have the green, why did I say green? You do have the Fool. Embrace your true purpose, begin a new adventure, trust yourself. And with this ego card here, this is ego getting in the way. This is your self-doubt. This is you actually, I'm not seeing it as devil energy, about negative energy or anything like that around you. This is you literally being negative with yourself, you know, that you doubt yourself. So you've got, make a decision here, get out of this mindset of that I can't do it, what are people going to think, people are not going to like, you know, that is the Empress energy. She's, you know, she worries. The Spirit wants you to take a leap of faith with this this gift, talent that you've got. So that Spirit really wants you to pursue this. So what advice would you give group two? What advice would you give group two? Nine of Summer, which is the Nine of Cups. This is wish fulfillment. Wishes come true, dreams fulfilled, a magical time in life. Tell me about this wish, please, Spirit. This is literally Spirit saying to you, you know, the advice here is that all your wishes will come true. Two of Summer as well. You've got a lot of emotions here. It's like your emotions are just going to be overflowing with happiness, love for what you do. So we've got the Two of Cups, which is the Two of Summer. Seven of Autumn, which is the Seven of Swords. Two of Swords. And Strength. The Magician. See, with this card here, okay, with the Two of Cups, yes, it can talk of falling in love, yes, it could be a soulmate here, but it's finding a resolution to a problem is what the card is saying. Don't give up. I feel like this is going to bring you healing energy as well. Like I said, your emotions are going to get really, like, you know, you're going to feel so excited. And then the Seven of Autumn here speaks of have patience and don't worry. Here we go. So with this Two of Autumn as well, this card actually says, which clarifies the Empress here, because the Empress, she's dragged in all different directions, okay? You know, she has to give her time to quite a lot of people, you know, and a lot of things. So with the Two of Autumn, we've got bring fun into everything you do, juggling multitasking priorities or jobs, an exceptional talent for multitasking. So Spirit is saying, if this is what is holding you back, is that you feel like that maybe you're being selfish, or you're going to have to juggle so many things or move things around here. You are somebody that is very talented for multitasking. You know, strength here, this card says it's time to embrace how wonderful you are. It's finding that courage to take that step into what it is that you want for yourself. It's time to start manifesting what you want. You know, you're quite capable of doing whatever it is that you can do. You have a talent. So you can do anything. Take a charge, take charge in your life. You can manifest what you need to bring success. But I feel like what's holding you back here, group two, is family, letting people down. It's like you've got this nature, this nurturing side of you, which is the Empress, of being so encouraging for other people, you know, giving them that boost, giving them that push, giving them, you know, like their biggest cheerleader. But when it comes to yourself, you doubt yourself every time. You may have even kept this talent, whatever this is here, that you can do from other people. Maybe it's you guys, you want to go travel the world now, that if your kids have flown the nest and it's like, I want to see the world, I haven't had time to do that. So let's get some oracle cards as well. So tell me for group two, please, the hidden gifts and talents for group two. What advice do you have? Shine your beauty. Let others do and say what they will. Keep doing good. Resist the temptation to dim your light to become as dark as those that oppose you. That's what I feel like you do, group two, is that you do dim your light. You let everybody else shine and you don't shine. It's really sad. The Empress. Yeah, the Empress sometimes doesn't get treated very well. So advice for group two's hidden talents and gifts. Divine masculine. There's excessive masculine energy that needs to be balanced in order to feel harmonious within. Take a step back and find a more feminine approach. Okay, so you've come out literally as divine masculine and feminine. Usually that I would say that was, you know, you being in alignment, okay, grounded. But Spirit is saying right now, you need to become more grounded, okay? Get in alignment with your feminine and masculine. It could be that your masculine is overtaking everything here. The divine masculine is usually the Emperor. This is somebody that likes to plan, likes to organize, likes to, you know, things done a certain way. Doesn't feel like things should come out of sorts, if you know what I mean. And it's like you're a provider. You need to provide for your family and care for your family. This is what the divine masculine is. But it seems like you're taking on the role of two people, like the masculine and the feminine. So it could be maybe you're a single parent as well. Okay, that was an important message from Spirit to you. Then we've got getting nowhere. You may need to adjust the lens in your life, change your mindset, and then change your lifestyle. You can still turn things around. So, you know, Spirit could be saying what you're doing every day, group two, is basically the same old thing over and over, and you're not really going anywhere, you're not really doing anything. What is there? So change your lifestyle. You can move things around. You do have the support that was right there at the beginning. People will support you if that's what you're worried about. Happy ending. Though it may not seem like it now, you will accomplish far more than you could ever imagine. Your story will have a happy ending. Lovely. And then we've got the little things. Find the little things in your everyday life that make you happy, and one day you'll realize they are the big things. So, message I didn't even ask anything, but anyway, power of three. Gather your closest allies to raise your cup, the cup, to rise to come in challenges. Now, you did have the three of cups as well. So it could be that you may need your allies, your friends, and that support for changing your lifestyle or pursuing whatever it is that you want. They're there to help you. In the cards, division gives you direction, but you have to take the steps. Now, that card's never come out in these cards, ever. So, literally, the cards are telling you here that your answers are in tarot. And it's giving you direction on how to take those steps. Candle magic. Holding your sacred rituals brings you peace and success. So you may want to do some candle magic. You know, light certain colour candles for success, love. You can find that on the internet. You can get books on Amazon as well about candle magic. But please, make sure it's good magic, okay? Not none of that dark stuff. So, group two's hidden talents and gifts, please, spirit. What advice? The butterfly. A time for transformation. Embrace the changes coming your way. So, you know, you may have to change some things around group two, okay? But spirit is saying don't fight against that. Embrace the change. The crown. Success and achievement. You are worthy of all the successes coming your way. Wow. So spirit is actually saying this is going to bring you a lot of success and a happy ending as well. If you can just take that little leap. The fall. The tree of life. Connection with everything around you. Notice the interpretance of life. So you may have a connection with everything around you, you know, like animals, trees, plants, you know, that kind of thing. Or maybe spirit is asking you to notice those things around you. That could even be signs from seeing maybe butterflies, birds, that you constantly keep seeing the same thing over and over. That's usually a sign as well. You could be seeing butterflies. Butterflies may be landing on you. I had a butterfly following me a couple of weeks ago. It just wouldn't go away. Not that I was faffing it away, but yeah, it followed me. And then it came into the house and I was like, oh my God, it's going to die. I'm so dramatic. But yeah, I put it back out, but it just wouldn't go. Anyway, so the lion, symbol of strength and courage, face your fears head on. Yep, you've had strength twice now. It's finding that strength, that courage, face those fears. That's lovely, that is as well. So let's get a message from your angels. So you've got Archangel Michael. I am with you, giving you the courage to make life changes that will help you work on your divine life purpose. So your angel is Archangel Michael, and he is there to give you that push, you know, encourage you. Wow. And then a message from your spirit guides. Be proud. It's time to celebrate all that you have achieved, all that you are, and all that you will become. Every once in a while, it's important to stop and acknowledge what you have achieved and be proud of it. So basically, you know, yeah, I feel like so many people rely on you, group two, not the other way around. So let me get a little bit more advice from spirit. So any more advice for group two? Five of Swords and the Eight of Cups. The Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, no. We even have the Travel card here, okay? We have the Ten of Pentacles and then the World, which is traveling, online business, you know, working with computers, There's something here that's going to bring you generational wealth and so much success and stability. But there's something here that you're having to deal with, or you're going to have to deal with to get to this here where you've completed something. I mean, this could have been completed. This is that's travel as well. Some of you, okay, you may have gone through toxic relationships. You may have been in a toxic relationship and you've had to walk away from that. You've completed something here in your life, or you're about to complete something. And you know, you invested a lot of time and energy into this, but you know, you feel really defeated. You feel like you failed. And I feel, I don't know why for you, group two, I do feel like you're on your own. That, you know, I said single parent. Or you know, you may be being a single parent for years now. And like I said, the children have flown the nest and now it's time for you. It could be as well here that spirit is telling you that things that you've experienced, where you've experienced defeat and being let down and people taking the mick out of you, it's time to leave that situation behind, or those situations behind as well, to go into your Ten of Pentacles here. So anyway, let's get you a question. So it doesn't have to be about this, guys. It could be about anything. So you can ask it out loud or think about it. So spirit for group two. So you've got two. You've got in a few months. Trust your inner voice. Your intuition will be your guiding force. And then not in this lifetime. That's very weird. This time has come to let go of the situation. Allow your angels to show you the way. Okay, so there's something maybe you've... Like I say, this sometimes we're torn between a few questions, and then like spirit tends to pick up on it. So one of them is in a few months, the other one is not in this lifetime. Anyway, so group two, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like. I appreciate you guys. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you. And thank you for staying and watching, guys. Much love. Hey, group three. So if you chose the Tiger's Eye Apple, this is your reading. So let's see what you got. You got, oh, they're wet. Oracle cards. You are able to discern answers and guidance for yourself and others. And then a healer. You have a spiritual gift of healing and a desire to share it with others. Wow. So, you know, healer can be a doctor, a nurse, or something like that, you know. But from these two together, I mean, I didn't look at the cards. You guys could have a gift with the oracle, you know, psychic gifts, mediumship, that kind of thing. For some of you, you guys may just do it for family and friends. It may not be anything that you've ever pursued professionally. I've said this before on my channel with me. I did it for like 30 years, just for friends and family. I've never really, you know, thought about doing this until a few years ago. And I got the courage, picked up the courage and decided to open a like YouTube channel. And I don't regret it now. It was just finding that confidence to do it. So this could be what's going on here, you know, or maybe you've wanted to read tarot cards or... you know, anything to do with the occult here, and you've just not, maybe you just don't know how to do it. Very interesting, group three, very interesting. So let's have a look. So, Spirit, tell me more about these Oracle cards and this Healer card for Group 3, their hidden talents and gifts. So, wow, the Sun, healing energy straight away. Number 16, which is life experience, which is the Tower. And the Princess of Summer, which is the Page of Cups. The Six of Spring, Six of Wands, wow. So on these cards, because these cards have certain meanings on them, okay? So you've got plans that work out perfectly, amazing ideas that lead to rewards and commendations. Gratitude for the blessings of life. Let go of belief systems that no longer work for you. An important life-changing event, a situation that leads to a significant opportunities. And then you guys are kind, sensitive, and inexperienced when it comes to this. So do you know what, before I even read any more of this, what I'm picking up straight away from this here is you have a healing energy, okay, a gift that needs to be shared with others, you know. And it could be that it's finally, I feel like something's happened recently with your Group 3, that you may have had a psychic episode or a download or something like that, that something happened and you knew about it before it was going to happen. And it looks like your gifts have started to develop. And maybe you're really shocked and scared by this with the Tower. It's like it came out of nowhere. So sometimes what happens as well is that trauma can bring about a psychic awakening, okay? But it's just that you're very inexperienced about it at the moment. You don't know how to hone in those gifts. You don't know what you're doing. You feel like, you know, what do I do? Who do I talk to? Where do I go with this? You know, where do I get advice from? I mean, I'm talking about experience with me a little while ago, that I had something that happened to me which really did freak me out because I thought I was going crazy. For God's sake. Even though I do this, okay, I'm going to sound like a right loony bin now, but I'm going to just say it, okay? Because I've said it before, my house is very haunted, but I see things happen, okay? So the other night, I've gone to go to bed, I've turned off the light, I have a spirit that used to like playing with a light of mine that I had, and I got rid of the light because it used to freak visitors out. And I bought a new light the other day, absolutely love it, this oil light, and I've switched it off. I sat down for about half an hour before I was going to bed, and it came on, and I thought, no way. So I got up, I switched it off. As I went to sit back down, the bloody thing came back on again. I was like, no. So I switched it off by the plug. I was like, here we go again. So it's like gifts like that. And they only tend to show me, not so much my family in the home. They do sometimes, but it's mainly me. But then as I was saying about this, where I'm going to sound a bit crazy, is I heard someone say something on a recording a while ago that I could only hear. And I know that sounds really crazy, but this is the type of thing that I'm trying to get with this. It's something that has awakened you to a gift, and it's like you don't know what to do with it, or you're going to be awakening to something here. And with this gift, you are a healer as well, Group 3. There's someone here that you could maybe talk to about this. Maybe someone who has a gift that maybe they can help you understand what's going on with you. Here it says, wonderful news is on its way. Smart choices bring reward, success and public recognition. So this could be something that your gift can end up bringing you some kind of public recognition here, like success. You know, this can even be fame. But this is a really beautiful energy. I need to clarify this here. This was unexpected. You wasn't expecting this. So maybe you guys got into meditation. Maybe started, I don't know, trying to open your third eye, that kind of thing, and this is where it's triggered it. But it also could be sometimes a really bad event in our life can trigger it as well. Tell me about this Princess of Summer. So we've got the Two of Spring, which is the Two of Wands, the Three of Winter, which is the Three of Swords. This was caused by a heartbreak. You went through something very traumatic, Group Three, and it's literally brought about this gift. And it also could be Group Three with this Three of Swords. It could be that you have the ability to heal people who have a broken heart, who are going through so much in their life. I mean, that is part of tarot, that is part of having this gift. Actually, it's healing, isn't it? It's just making that decision here, making the choice that's right for you, not being scared of the unknown. So we do have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces and Leo. So tell me a bit more about Group Three's gifts and talents, Spirit. Release in reverse, which is 13, which is death. You're fearful of this. This scares you, Group Three. And it also could be, because we've got this broken heart here, you've gone through something quite bad. It could be that you're so scared of moving forward, moving on, ending things with someone or something here. It could be that you don't want to let go of this heartbreak that you're holding on so tightly, and it could be affecting the gift that you have. But it also could be that you are fearful of what this is. Tell me about, sort of Scorpio, tell me about death in reverse. Many wands, King of Wands and the Seven of Wands. So financial windfall, your leadership skills are needed now, exclamation mark, an unexpected supporter at your cause. And then you've got someone who's theatrical, very wise. And then you've got be assertive, don't back down from what you believe, courageously stand up for yourself. Wait, bear with me. Tell me about this King of Spring and the Seven of Spring. Temperance. This is somebody that could help you, somebody you may know who is a King of Spring that is wise. This could be like a teacher or somebody you can go and talk to that's going to help you feel, bring you some peace. Okay, maybe, like I said, you freaked out about it. Then you've got the Page of Cups, and then you've got the Page of Coins. Yeah, see. You know, this is, I'm seeing this as you're still quite young, not as in young, maybe physically, not young in that sense, your age. It's that you're still like, you know, like an apprentice, like you're still learning your craft. You're going to be learning, studying about this. You're going to be looking into things. And I feel like it might be a King of Wands that is, and don't forget the energies, it can be any kind of energy, that is going to help you on your journey with this, make you understand it more. This is someone that you can depend on, a loyal friend. But at the moment, because you're so maybe naive or not experienced enough at the moment, group three, you need a master, basically. This is a King of Wands. He's a master. You know, this also can be speaking of you guys wanting to do this on your own. And sometimes it's not best to do it on your own. Sometimes it's best to seek advice, seek help from someone else. So you have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sagittarius and Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well. Yeah, you need to seek advice from somebody. So, any more advice in regards to this gift, whatever? So, we've got the Seven of Cups, the Tower in reverse, the Ace of Coins in reverse, Strength in reverse, oh my god, and the Six of Wands now in reverse. Spirit saying you're resisting this change. You're resisting it. You've got the Tower twice. It's upright. Now it's reversed. But this is your energy that what's happening here. So this is what's happened. But this is now your energy here where you're resisting this change. It's like you don't want it. It's like, no, thank you. I don't want this. Yeah, it's like you really don't want this. But the thing is, Spirit is saying you can't break away from this. No matter what you try and do, it's there. You know, it's there to stay is what I'm hearing. It's like you've got a choice that you can either keep avoiding it, keep it to yourself, not talk to anybody else, and you know, keep, you know, not suffer. It's not suffering is a crap thing to say, but Spirit is saying you're missing out on an opportunity here that could bring you a lot of success. Like I said, there's fame here, there's rewards here. But you're not embracing this, which is pretty sad, really. You doubt yourself. Could also be that there may be a warning here with this Strength in reverse, guys, okay? Because you may be leaving yourself vulnerable. You do need to protect yourself. Because you can get psychic attacks. You can also pick up other people's energies. So when you're doing this kind of thing, and I've said this before, and I've also given advice to other people, when you're doing this kind of thing, you need to protect your energy at all costs. So it's like meditation, salt baths, you know, cleansing, that kind of thing. So you are leaving yourself open here. And I don't want to scare you, but, you know, it's like you don't want to surrender to this. That I feel like it's not not tarot cards, guys. I feel like I was trying to explain about my certain experiences when it comes to a gift that I have. And yeah, it does freak certain people out. It does. I think when you hear voices, it's not that you're crazy, okay? People tend to, maybe that's what you're fearful of, is that people think you're crazy. Maybe this is why you've kept it to yourself. I think that's I can't even say that word. You've got clairvoyance, clairaudience, that sounds wrong. But Google the clairs, okay? If you've got that gift where you're hearing things, you're seeing things, that kind of thing, and it's starting to freak you out, try and read up on it and understand it a bit more. But it's like spirit feels let down here with this Six of Wands in reverse. It's like they feel that that they've let you down, which is quite sad, really. Yeah, spirit's advice to you here is stop blocking us out. We're here to help you, you know. Stop avoiding this gift that was given to you. It's a blessing, really, is what spirit's saying. It is a blessing. So let's get some oracle cards. So for group three, please, spirit, the hidden gifts and talents. Wow, that's a lot. Do that again. And gifts and talents for group three. So we've got the autumn leaf. Oh, that's a spare one. Okay. Now that's actually kind of weird. I've never seen that in this deck. Okay, there is a lot of cards, you know. Then we've got the drum. I'm seeing that. That's never happened before. It's either you can start from a blank canvas, you know. Start from the beginning. It also could be because there's nothing on here. It's like, I don't know, I'm just seeing it as being like you're avoiding this. I don't know. Autumn leaf. Change and release. Embrace change as a part of life. And then we've got the drum. Rhythm and life's heartbeat. Connect with the beat of your life's journey. So, you know, spirit saying release this fear. Crystal. The crystal. We've got clarity and transformation. Harness your inner power and manifest your desires. And then we've got the feather, lightness and freedom, release your burdens and fly high. And then the sky, infinite possibilities, the sky's the limit. Yeah, look, at this is so positive. It's just letting go of that fear. So for group three, please, spirit, the hidden gifts and talents. So we have believe in miracles. You have to take risks. Miracles will only happen if you allow the unexpected to happen. And then we've got guided lessons. Your higher self is guiding you to make mistakes so you can learn important lessons. So maybe this is just like a bit of a stepping stone, you know, a bit of a lesson at the moment until you maybe accept those gifts. Maybe some of you went through this and then you are now embracing these gifts. And then we've got reconciliation. There is someone or something that can still be saved if you choose to compromise. Try to find the middle ground between two points. I don't see this as a reconciliation between someone and you. It's a reconciliation between your gift and yourself. So this could be something that you had in your past lives that now your soul is trying to reconnect that part of you with it. But you're avoiding it. And then we have trust your power. Your impact in the world is greater than you think. Whether you see it or not, your existence makes a positive difference. See, this is what I'm saying. Maybe you're too scared to mention it to people because they may think that you're crazy. Like I said, you know, people are going to think I'm crazy when I start telling that story. But, you know, some people don't understand it. Can't escape your shadow self until you make the unconscious consciousness conscious. It will continue to direct your life. So you need to work on your shadow self, guys. Some meditation there. So, root, free peace, spirit, they're hidden. Gifts and talents, I don't think so. We're not doing half the deck. Oh, blimey. Reflection. As you gaze into your past, you will see the way to the future. And I do feel like that's exactly what I just said here. Your past is your previous life, not your past in general. Maybe you got a gift with crystal balls. Holding intention, working with magical tools helps focus your power. Okay, here you go. But then that's if you want to do it, guys. So it could be holding, you know, working with certain magical tools is going to help focus that power, you know, like crystals and things like that. And also harness that power to develop it. Good timing. Check as astrological transits to get the best dates for planning. So if you're going to do this, check that astrological whatever. Oh my god, I'm losing my freaking cards. Here we go. So, point three is hidden gifts and talents, please, spirit. We've got breakthrough. A significant breakthrough is near. Whatever you're going through is preparing you for the big break, discovery, progress, big boost. So you could be going through a traumatic experience right now that's going to give you this awakening here to your gifts. Also with that King of Wands, this could be somebody already in your life that you can actually trust. Breaking molds, breakthrough boundaries, erase all identifications, anything which fixes you permanently into one mold, new way, different, and you're unique. I like being called unique instead of weird. I hate people that say that I'm weird. That's not the right word. I'm unique. Anyway, so we're group three. Conquering, victory will be yours. Set the intention and watch it come back to you. Overcoming victory and success. Now you've had the Six of Wands three times now. That is the Six of Wands basically, but you've had it twice upright, one, you know, one's in reverse. Right, let's get you a message from your angels. Maybe you've got that one angel around you at the moment. Wow. Mystique. Keep charging ahead and don't take no for an answer. Expect miraculous solutions to appear. So your angel is Mystique. That sounds like And then you've got Shanti. I am the angel of peace. I bring you new tranquility and a smoother road ahead. And let's get one from your spirit guides. Okay, you've got two. So we've got memories. Your memories are like diamonds in a treasure chest of spirit. More and more memories are arising within you. Remember the happier moments with your loved ones who are here in spirit, the spirit world, for neither time nor distance can stop the energy of love that you have for one another. I'm seeing this as well, that spirit is actually telling you your memories that are coming back to you could be from your previous life, that's reminding you that you had a gift that was asleep for a long time. Yeah. I feel like you've got like a direct line to spirit. Listen. You have to be willing to listen if you want to really understand someone. Now is not the time to be offering advice, but to be a compassionate listener. To listen fully and intently means to pay attention, not to just what's being said, but to what lies beneath the words. So this could be even this tarot reading. Listen, it could be you asking this King of Wands for advice. Listen is what spirit is saying. Even listen to spirit, I reckon, as well. Listen for the signs, listen for the synchronicities, angel numbers. So ask a question or think of a question. It doesn't have to be about this, it can be about anything you want. So for group three, please, spirit. Okay, that's too many. Can we just like get one or two? Yeah, there you go. Blocked for your highest good. Open your mind to the possibility that you deserve more than what you're asking for. So whatever you ask for, you're blocked for your highest good. It's like you're not. Spirit saying no, basically, to this. And then on the back of the deck, you actually have time interference. There are other people's free will affecting this situation. So group three, just rang the bell by accident. Maybe that's a sign as well. So anyway, group three, I'm going to leave it there, okay? If you like this reading, please hit like. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you. Thank you for watching, guys. Much love.